If you've typed on a computer, chances are you've typed on a keyboard with the QWERTY layout. In fact, if you enter any office, school, or workplace, all you will find are computers with the QWERTY style layout. Many don't question it, but when you actually think about it, there are some things about the QWERTY layout that don't really make sense. Like, why is there an entire home row key dedicated to semicolon when it's barely even ever used? So I went on an investigation to see if the QWERTY layout is still up to par with modern times. I started looking into the history of QWERTY and questioning everything I knew about touch typing. Why do we use the QWERTY layout? Where did it come from? Why is it so popular? Is it really the best layout to use when touch typing? Are there better options already out there? Should I switch my layout for typing? I'm Anson Alexander, I'm a touch typing instructor, and if you hang around, I will answer all of these questions and more as I investigate the infamous QWERTY style keyboard and its modern alternatives. The name QWERTY comes from the first six letters on the keyboard. It was first developed in 1873, yes, 1873, for the Scholes and Glidden typewriter. There's much discussion and speculation as to why the way QWERTY is laid out the way it is, but one thing seems for certain, that many alternatives were tried and tested before finally arriving at QWERTY. Some say that the design came from the way that telegraph operators worked at the time. Some say it was to balance the internal load of the typewriter's mechanism so that you weren't typing keys next to each other at the same time. Despite there being a lot of literature on the history of typing and keyboard layouts, there doesn't seem to be a clear exact reason as to why the QWERTY layout was chosen. It seems that many considerations were taken into account to arrive at the QWERTY layout that we know today. I found it disappointing that there wasn't a clear reason as to why we use QWERTY. I was hoping this would clue me in on whether or not QWERTY is a timeless layout or whether it's way past its prime. Needless to say, it was created a really long time ago, especially in the context of modern computing history. So I have a hunch that we can find something better. But why do we still use it today? Well, it was essentially released on the very first typewriter ever, so typists at the time went out and learned the QWERTY layout. When it came time to release updated typewriters, they didn't change the layout because they didn't want to risk typists not using the new typewriters because it had a different layout. Even when competitors entered the market, they also went with the QWERTY layout so that typists could just buy their new typewriter and start typing. And this has gone on for, well, over 100 years, and here we are today using modern computing machines that people couldn't even have dreamed of in the late 1800s, yet we're still giving them input on a keyboard layout designed way before computers were ever even invented. It's actually quite amazing when you really think about it how this layout has been able to stand the test of time. But despite being an efficient QWERTY typist, I'm not convinced it will last forever. But if history holds true, maybe it will. Okay, so QWERTY is a legend. I've got that. But I'm still not convinced it's the best. It's time to branch out and see if there are some alternative layouts and if there's any data or evidence that supports other layouts being more efficient than QWERTY. The first QWERTY alternative usually mentioned is Dvorak, not named for its keyboard layout, but for its inventor, Dr. August Dvorak. He discovered that only 32% of typing was actually done on the home row on a QWERTY layout. So he set out to design a new layout that would reduce the overall finger movement on the keyboard. On a Dvorak keyboard, 70% of typing is done on the home row. Now this sounds exactly like what I'm looking for. The downside is that the layout is almost entirely different from a QWERTY layout, so there is a steep learning curve, but hey, if it's the most efficient method, maybe it's worth it. However, there is another alternative that may be easier to pick up than Dvorak, but still an improvement on QWERTY. Let me introduce you to the Colemak layout. With this layout, 74% of the typing is done on the home row, but it was designed in a way to make it similar to QWERTY and therefore easier to learn. However, one of the issues with the Colemak layout is that typists claim the proximity of the H and E keys make it difficult to type quite a few English words, especially when you're getting into the higher words per minute, above 80 words per minute, because there are a lot of words that have H and E right next to each other, and it creates an awkward position on the keyboard. This is something that's concerning to me because I already type at over 100 words per minute on a QWERTY layout, so I'm looking for something that can improve upon that. Either way, it's an interesting option when looking for a more efficient keyboard layout without having to relearn all of the keys over again. There is another, more recent option, however, and that is the Workman layout. This layout was developed more recently and is supported by default on Linux computers. Instead of basing the layout on how many times each key is used when typing, this layout focuses on lowering the overall travel distance of your fingers. In fact, according to an article cited on Wikipedia, this layout reduces the overall travel distance of your fingers even compared to the Colemak layout. Okay, at this point on my journey to find out if our way of typing needs to change, I feel a little better. I've found some alternatives that seem to have the same idea in mind that I'm looking for. However, I've also thought of a major drawback. What do I do about the whole keyboard situation? I mean, I actually have a mechanical keyboard, so I could actually, you know, take these keys off and move them around, and then I could reprogram my computer for a different keyboard layout, but yeah, I'm not going to do that, at least not yet. That's too much work for something that I don't even know if I'm going to stick with. So I guess I could buy a cheap one on Amazon specifically for an alternate layout. The problem still remains though. Everywhere I go, I'm stuck with QWERTY, and maybe that's not a huge deal because I'm a pretty fast typer with QWERTY, but if I learn a new layout, will I forget? And so herein lies the problem. There are good reasons to try a different keyboard layout, but not learning how to type QWERTY isn't really an option. I mean, if your company gives you a work laptop, what are you going to drag your Colemak keyboard with you everywhere you go? But at the same time, if nobody branches out and tries to learn and promote alternative layouts, then they'll never be adopted by greater society. So it's really a catch-22, and it's the history of typing and keyboarding and QWERTY all coming together here in modern times. Can we move away from QWERTY? I don't know. Despite not getting a clear answer on what the most efficient keyboard layout is, I don't think it's QWERTY, especially when you compare it to modern alternatives that have been designed with efficiency in mind and that have been designed, well, after computers were invented. So I'm going to learn a new keyboard layout and document my journey here on YouTube. Which layout am I going to learn? Well, I'm leaning towards Colemak, but I want your input as well. Let me know in the comments section which one you like best if you've tried alternates, and if you haven't tried alternates, let me know which one you'd like to see me go for. I'm going to learn the new layout with the same methods that I teach the QWERTY layout here on YouTube, which is something that you should check out if you haven't learned QWERTY yet. I'm both nervous and excited, but I'm hoping I can maybe help pave the way for other typists who are looking to branch out and be bold. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more typing content, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And once I start learning a new layout, I'll post the first video right here on YouTube so that you can see how I'm faring on my journey. Thanks again for stopping by. I wish you speed and accuracy as you journey about typing on your keyboards. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.